Solve for x. We have 1 half x plus 3x minus 7 equals 13. So to combine the 1 half x and the 3x, I need to make a common denominator. The common denominator will be 2. So 3 times 2 over 2, that's 3 over 1 times 2 over 2. 3 times 2 is 6 divided by 1 times 2, which is 2. So 1 half x plus 6 over 2 times x minus 7 equals 13. So let's add 1 half plus 6 halves, that's 7 halves. And the x is still there. Minus 7 equals 13. Add 7 to both sides. So bring down the 7 halves x. Negative 7 plus 7 makes 0. So then we're going to have equals 13 plus 7, which is 20. Multiplied by the reciprocal, that's 2 over 7. So this simplifies to just x because it makes 14 divided by 14. So we get our x equals 20 times 2, which is 40, and then divided by 1 times 7, which is 7. So x equals 47ths. I'm going to divide that to make it a mixed number, so it makes a little more sense to me what that value is. 40 divided by 7, well, 7 goes in there 5 times. 5 times 7 is 35. So 40 minus 35 is 5, and then 7 does not go into 5, and we're not going to go into a decimal here by putting 0.0. So the answer is 5 5/7. Now I'm going to take a minute and check my answer here using the calculator, because last time, yeah, it didn't go so well. So let's see, 47ths. So I'm going to use 47ths instead of 5 5/7. It just makes it a little easier to put in the calculator. So I'm going to do 1 half, or 1 divided by 2, and then times 40 divided by 7. My calculator knows order of operations, so I can just input as is. 3 times, so I put plus 3, and then times, I'm going to put my 47ths again, 40 divided by 7, and then minus 7. Okay, so I inputted the whole left side, and if my answer is right, it should equal to 13. Perfect. So now I know my answer works. 5 5/7 or 47ths is the correct answer. So I'm going to go ahead and circle my 5 5/7.